A lot of Alabama folks playing very, very, very good cornhole right now.
Yeah, Alabama, they're going to bring it every time, right?
All right. Yeah, that state championship and the Kentucky state championship always.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of great battles within.
I'm sure Jack Harcrow would be happy to say that he won.
Oh, he'll be the first one to step out there. Bama proud. Congratulations to Jack.
Yeah, Mr. Bearpaw looks like he might pick up the first skin.
Yeah.
Didn't even, yeah, he does have to throw it. Oh, he let him off the hook, though. Wow. Scotty takes advantage right there to get the carryover.
How about that?
And I did not expect that from Gary Bearpaw.
No, not after those first two bags.
But you saw how quick that bag stopped. I'm telling you, these boards are sticky to some bags.
Which is crazy because it's cold in here.
Yeah.
It's cold in this room, you would think. But I've heard a lot of people thought that colder without the humidity makes them faster. But some people have told me that colder makes them slower. I don't see how that's possible, but...
I've always seen when it's colder, they were a lot faster.
Yeah, but somebody told me that the physics of it actually is the opposite. Now, I don't play to this level. I don't play hardly at all, but it doesn't seem to make sense to me. Yeah, he went up high and he rolled off to the side. That could be a great opportunity now for Scotty.
And that's all he needed to do?
Stack it up. Gary will lay it low. He's just going to walk it down there and take those first two skins. Is Scotty Ball off Gary Bearpaw. Early 2-0 lead on the skins. Oh, my goodness. What is it? Oh, my God, I'm allergic to it. No, it's perfect. I'm just playing. Thank you, man. I appreciate that.
I'm sorry.
Oh, that's great. I appreciate that, Dustin. Or Dylan. Cheers to you. He probably looked back at me and said, good, I hope you choked to death. Oh, now here we go. Now we're finding the groove.
Oh, and Scotty opened it up.
You're welcome.
Now, Gary did not go in. I'm telling you, I saw Gary make some mistakes over there in co-ed. I think he was throwing the other lady's bags.
Yep.
The mistakes that I have never really seen him make.
That was a Gary C, Gary Do.
Yeah. Gary's just going to take the wash.
Low and take the wash and move on to the next skin and the next frame. Sometimes a smart play. Sometimes aggressive play is the way to go. But when you're sitting down, only down 2-0, you've got a lot of time to make up.
And that's a two-point carryover.
What you need.
One-point carryover. So this one's
good
just for
one.
Two.
This will be for two.
Yeah. Oh, look at this, man.
Done it again.
This guy may have let him off the hook again. Wow.
What is going on?
I don't know, but I wish he'd have called me out.
Yeah, right. Right. Yeah. That's what he gets.
There was a throwback by Gary.
That's what he gets for puffing his chest out at you. Coming across. Run it right up the middle.
He got one to fall, and it's going to be tough.
Yep. Gary trying to plug it up. Oh, his other one fell.
Yeah,
he's going to do it. They're going to leave it there.
That's going to be four for Scotty.
Pick up two more, so that puts him 4-0 up over Gary Bearpaw.
Would you call this an upset if he were to win completed?
Oh, yeah. No question, because a lot of folks picked Gary to win the entire Pro Series skins, not the least of which the guy to my left. Up and over. Oh, boy, and Gary is just not dialed in today.
Why could he not call me out?
Now, you know what would have happened if he called you out. It'd
he
be over.
He wouldn't have missed this.
It'd be a bit over by now. He'd have gotten 13 skins on the first frame, and he'd have been like, what happened?
And I don't know if that was a good bag by Scotty, man.
Took a risk.
With nothing down.
Underneath, yeah.
Why? You got to make sure you keep that bag on, man.
Yeah, now we're just looking at an ugly wash.
All you got to do is knock one in.
One
fell right there, and he picks up a skin.
All right, Gary Bearpaw, that's a unique way to grab that first one, but he does just that. Four on one. Scotty Ball holds the lead over Gary Bearpaw. I'm going to have to stand up here for a minute because my belt buckle is cutting off the circulation to the lower half of my body. I've been sitting here all day.
And now they're going hole for hole. Fins are coming up. Oh, it's coming up.
You think? No, look at you.
If I tell you it's Easter. I thought that was the last bag.
There you go. There you go, dum-dum.
I was already, look, I was already over here.
You had it hoisted. that moves the total 4-2. Scotty Ball holds a slight advantage over Gary Bearpaw, who is lucky to only be down 4-2.
Yeah, he really
at this
is.
Point.
But he looks like he might be trying to get in the groove here.
And again, once we get through these last matches, we'll redraw or have them redraw against one another and choose their opponents. Or as I like the way LaBelle put it earlier, pick your poison, because
yeah,
that's
really
exactly what you could be doing. Quite a few did. Seven players in that first round, 16 matches, got beaten by the person they chose to play against.
Isn't that great? I was happy to myself.
You were one of them.
Yeah.
I love it.
Scotty up and over right here.
Going up. And
nice job.
Drops it down.
Picks up the skin.
All right, he's going to grab another one.
Five on two, four, two.
Five on two, heading into round number 8 of 13. Again, welcome to the Branson Convention Center here at the Hilton on Branson Landing. Finn, the loudmouth for the ACO, the Mississippi Ninja, Philip Barnett, side by side after a big day on the boards for you, my man.
Yeah, I've had a good time today.
Seniors championship game. Tomorrow you got doubles and singles both.
Yes, sir. I need a top 10 finish tomorrow, Finn.
All right. So it is said, so it shall be done.
Nice.
All right.
I'm not going to say it.
Is he going to do it? And he
there's
does it.
There's the finish, baby.
Cheers to you.
It's my time.
Yeah, now if you had said it.
Yeah, he would have missed.
Uh-huh. All right, so that's a push. They'll take that on into round number 9. This one's worth 50 buh. 50 buh.
Yeah.
Did you watch the Tom Brady roast?
Oh, my gosh. Was that not the funniest thing
I love
ever?
It. Kevin Hart introduces Nikki Glaser. She says, thank you, 15 cent.
Yeah.
She was the best.
She was
so
great,
good.
Yeah.
I think we're going to have to do a roast of Frank here someday.
Oh, well, can I get in it?
Yeah, absolutely.
Man, we need a roast of Gary Bearpaw.
No, yeah. That'll be the shortest roast
in
the history of roast.
It wouldn't last
long. Nobody would be able to think of one thing to say that isn't nice about him.
That's right. He is a nice guy.
Up and over. Oh, boy. And he took the risk to try to make it happen right there, and that just did not do it. And
Gary going to pick up one?
Gary's going to pick up two, actually, there, because
really?
we had a push. So that moves it to 5-on-4 now. 7:36 Central Time, 8:36 Eastern, 5:36 West Coast. I'm sorry.
Vegas time. What time is it in Vegas?
I have no idea. You never know. They don't have any clocks.
It's got to be.
Daytime. It's always daytime.
5:37. P.M.
Yes. Not that that matters in Vegas.
Yeah. They're piling them up. Looks like they both got one down.
Mm-hmm. No, boy.
Scotty went for the big push.
Gary is going to, oh, nice. He lifted them up and dropped them down. And
there we go.
That'll be another push heading into frame number 11. And, again, if you like what you see there and you want to figure out exactly what it is you're looking at, you can go to the American Cornhole Organization website, americancornhole.com. Pro skins is on there, but there are also rules for backyard skins. A little bit different, but it just kind of shows you how to set it up and how to tally, how to throw a frame game maybe to get your seedings together if you want to do that. Also, handicapping if you'd like to check out how to play. Maybe you've got a few people in your group that are better than everybody else, but you can throw some frame games and set up your handicap, and that extends the fun in a lot of games as well. So all of that there for you, just part of the innovations, just like this skins game is to the game of cornhole with Scotty Ball, one out of play there, and it just continues to get further out of play. Gary's not going to do him any favors here. He's just going to run it up the middle and
pick up
his
skin.
And he does. Oh, actually, he's going to pick up two again because we had a push. We were working off a push, and now he takes the lead 6-5 with two frames left. Is Gary going to be able to pull victory out of the jaws of defeat?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Scotty didn't take advantage on the ones he should have.
Yeah.
But he still has five skins.
Yep. Well, the number of times you've said that if you don't take points when you can get it from certain players, you will regret it all night long.
I'm going to be regretting all those open boards that Tyler Amos gave me that I didn't finish and get those skins. I mean, you think about that. You got to take advantage of every – when you're playing at this level, if somebody's got one out of play, or you better take advantage of that.
Well, if they're going to do you a favor, you should let them. You know,
that's right.
It's going to sound stupid when I say this, but it's never stopped me before. All right.
6-on-6. Oh, here we go.
Scotty Ball.
Next winner wins. Next hole winner wins. Yeah. How about that? Is that better?
But the thing about if somebody's going to do you a favor, let them.
Yeah.
My dad used to always say that. My dad was a banker, right? But he would still use coupons. And I'm like, really? And he goes, if somebody's going to give me money, I'm going to take it.
Absolutely.
Even if it's 60 cents or, you know, a dollar off of two, if stuff you're going to buy anyway, if somebody's going to give you money, take it. That's the best financial advice I ever got.
There you go. I agree with that.
I walk around. I stack them up in the order with which I go around the grocery store. I know exactly the order I'm going to get them. Save $7 or $8.
All right, they both got one down. Scotty,
he's going up. Oh, he missed off the backside. He's just all risk.
And that's for the game.
No reward.
That's going to do it.
Oh, and that does it, Gary Bearpaw. How about that? Very well played game by Scotty Ball. Nicely done, but Gary Bearpaw comes out the victor.